Courtney Neufeld's dream has just come true. And it's because we've received piles and piles of letters from her friends telling us the most unbelievable story of strength and survival.
Courtney's just a miracle.
Courtney's promising future was ripped away almost 2 years ago when a drunk driver nearly ended her life.
I felt like somebody just ripped my heart right out.
Yet she defied the odds and battled her way back to life.
She had to learn how to talk again, learn how to eat.
Now she's ready to move out of her bedroom and into a brand new suite of her own. And we've got $25,000 to do it up right. This is the story of a brave young woman and her mother's dedication you don't want to miss. Every day the letters arrive, calling on us to reward the most remarkable people in the country. Our gift is a $25,000 makeover delivered by a talented team who transform rooms and change lives. These are the everyday heroes and inspired designs of Makeover Wish. Hello, I'm Erin Sebula with designer Keith Chalmers.
Hi there.
And this is just one of many letters we received telling the story of a remarkable family who faced a tragedy that no family should endure. Courtney Neufeld was headed for greatness, a Harvard-bound student at the top of her class. Her dream was to one day change the criminal law system and make a difference in the world.
She's like one of the hardest workers I've ever seen in my entire life.
She's always been really intelligent.
She had big dreams. A very good daughter, treated me very well. Then the lightning bolt struck.
Driving home late at night, only a few blocks from her house, a drunk driver slammed into Courtney, leaving her for dead. The doctors struggled to save Courtney's life, but the damage to her brain was severe.
It was more than likely that she would never come out of the coma. And if she did, she would be a vegetable. It was like we had lost her. We just thought, oh, she's never gonna come out of her coma. And did I tell her I loved her enough? We spent 2 weeks in the hallway waiting to see if she'd come out of her coma.
Weeks later, Courtney opened her eyes, but things weren't the same. She couldn't even sit up. She had to relearn everything.
It was like starting from about 6 months old and coming right back to being a 22-year-old.
Now start adding this on to it.
6, 7, 8, 9.
And then after struggling day after day, Courtney said her first word. Mom.
It was a really great moment. It really was. It was Mom.
And what else is it?
Chocolate.
That's it.
Yeah.
Courtney's come a long way, and her friends think she can go even farther.
This is just such a big next step for her to get out on her own and have her new life.
You guys wrote some amazing letters, and I know Keith is excited. Are we ready to surprise Courtney?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Courtney deserves this gift because she inspires people, I think, more so now, if that's possible, than before.
She deserves this, and she's been through a lot.
I think she just needs a reward for having her life ripped out from underneath her and being strong-willed enough to try to get it back.
Hi, Courtney.
Hi.
How are you?
How are you?
Good. My name's Erin Sebula. I'm from the TV show Makeover Wish. Mm-hmm. That's what all this fuss is about. And we're here because all of your friends and your family, so many people, wrote us letters telling us about what a remarkably strong, gorgeous, awesome girl you are. Yes. Yes. And I want to read you part of the letter.
Okay.
Dear Makeover Wish, our great friend Courtney and her entire family faced an unimaginable tragedy 2 years ago. Devastated by a horrific car accident, Courtney, with the love and support of her mom, has fought her way back from the brink of death day by day and step by step. She's a beautiful, strong young woman, and we know this makeover will be part of her new beginning.
Hi, Courtney. My name is Keith Chalmers. Hi. I'm an interior designer, and I've been given $25,000 to make a space, a fantastic space, just for you. It's our gift to you.
Yeah. You're on the wall. She's gone.
Jumping for joy. That's Courtney.
That was, without a doubt, one of the best moments of my entire life. Really.
I've never seen anyone react that way. I'm so happy for you. Yeah. It's gonna be great. You're gonna love it. It's gonna be very cool. Well, when all the hugging is done and the very excited Courtney is ready to go, the team is going to move in and we are gonna go to work transforming her basement into a brand new cool suite that she can call her very own. It's a lot of work, a monster job, and we have only 3 days to do it, so we better get going. And the first step is sending Courtney away to a lakeside resort.
This is how it's good. I'm up here. I'm just having a good time already.
Bye, Courtney. Bye.
See you later, bye. Courtney.
See you later. Later. Yeah. Courtney won't be returning to her small bedroom upstairs because we're converting the entire lower floor into a private new suite. Ooh. Oof. It's green.
It's very green, and it's not a good green.
No, it's a little old.
It's a little old. The paint's gotta go, the furniture's gotta go, the carpet's gotta go. It's all gotta go.
It feels like it's sort of been neglected. It's kind of been this area where you put things where that don't have a place, basically. Where's she gonna sleep and eat?
She's gonna sleep and eat in the next two rooms.
It doesn't look like a kitchen, Keith.
You're right, Erin. It doesn't look like a kitchen, but it's going to look like a kitchen. It's a sewing room, it's a family room, it's a laundry room, and we just need to completely change it. It's gonna be fresh, and it's gonna be young, just like Courtney. So all this stuff has to go.
Start with the chairs, the smaller things should go first, and then the larger things second, but everything goes, nothing stays.
We're taking the fan off, Jeff. Can you reach up there and do those screws?
Making up Courtney's three-room suite means three times the work for Keith and his design team.
Okay, Dan, we've cleared out the laundry, but there's still not enough room for this kitchen. So you know what that means?
Yeah, let's take this wall out.
Suite for an inspiring young woman. And it's all coming up next on Makeover Wish. Courtney Neufeld is an amazing young woman. Not only did she survive a horrific car accident 2 years ago, but she made a miraculous recovery that no one expected. But it wasn't easy. Courtney had to relearn all the things that we take for granted. How to move, how to eat, and how to talk.
It was like starting from about 6 months old and coming right back to being a 22-year-old.
And now she's ready for the next stage in her life, independence, and a place that she can call her own. And we have $25,000 to make it all happen. First, we cleared out the rooms. And then, we made more room by knocking out a wall.
It's a great way to release tension.
And I'm letting off steam, too. Over drinks with Courtney and Carmen at their old stomping ground.
Do you think about how amazing it is that you've
gotten this far in your recovery now. And
oh, I'm so glad.
It was really nice to see Courtney spending time with Carmen, a friend who stuck with her this entire time, at the actual restaurant where she was working the night of the accident. And it's nice to see that she's strong enough to be able to go back there and have good times with her friend.
Do you remember that lady that you dumped the salad down her back when she was sitting at the table? Oops.
Okay, crew, this is the plan. The living room is comfortable. It's meant for Courtney to be able to enjoy the space with her friends. It's really comfortable, overstuffed, red, bright colors, neutralized by the wall color.
Then we're gonna go into the kitchen, which is gonna be a lot of work for you, Dan, because
it's kind of a starter kitchen. It'll get Courtney's independence started.
Courtney's gonna love it. There's a lot of work to do. Let's go, guys.
All right.
Okay guys, we're gonna use three colors in the space. We're gonna do one neutral taupe and two accents. The first accent's a really rich dark brown that we're gonna put on the fireplace wall to give it some punch. And we're not gonna look at the cornice and the baseboard separately, we're gonna look at it as one linear block. So we're gonna do color blocking as opposed to trimming. And we're gonna make it easy on you, and Jen is gonna start labeling the spaces for us.
Backyard becomes a workshop for assembling Courtney's new furniture. Meanwhile, the renovation requires a little innovation from Keith inside. What are you going to do about this weird ledge?
This weird ledge is a common problem. It's a protruding foundation. And what we want to do is take this bench idea, the idea of a TV bench, and we're just going to rest it up against the foundation and create a bench and a sort of a banquette with some loose cushions.
Oh, good idea.
How do you stuff an 8-foot piece of foam?
Carefully. Do it like a nylon. And you grab the foam, and if we pull it to the edge, oh, it didn't work.
Is it too thin?
Anybody have any WD-40? No one's noticing that it's taking two of us to stuff a pillow, while in the next room, one guy is carpeting the entire floor by himself. Well, we've knocked down walls and installed plush new carpet. After the break, a truckload full of gorgeous furniture will arrive, and this room will really start to take shape. You don't want to miss it. We are giving a $25,000 makeover to Courtney Neufeld, an incredible young woman who defied the odds and fought her way back from a devastating car accident 2 years ago. Courtney's mother was told her only daughter wouldn't survive the severe brain injury.
Just hard. It felt like somebody just ripped my heart right out. Really, just such pain. It's just unbelievable.
But Courtney clawed her way back, relearning life from scratch. Her recovery has been amazing. And we are giving her the gift of a lifetime, a cool new suite that she can call her own. Courtney jumped for joy when her wish came true.
She's gone! I'm home!
Now we're turning half the house into a new apartment for Courtney so she can finally move out of her bedroom and feel independent.
Courtney's just a miracle. Everything about her, she's just beaten every obstacle that was placed in front of her. She deserves it more than anyone I could think of.
Okay guys, let's bring in Courtney's kitchen. Whatever the gap is there, let's do the gap here.
This is art, fast art. This is simply painting MDF panels and then mounting them on the wall. It's the reason for that is just to give it a graphic feel and to tie it in with the accent wall opposite.
She's roaring, raring, ready to go to have her own place and, you know, wash her own dirty dishes.
Inside, the design team adds some personal touches for Courtney, while outside, Keith improvises an easy way to add sparkle to the room.
Okay, Jen, we're gonna make some really cool candle wall sconces for Courtney's living room.
Okay.
It's really simple. You just take two pieces of MDF like that.
Okay.
and then you just glue them together like this, and we're going to paint them that really cool charcoal gray accent that we're using in the living room.
Beautiful.
We're going to put a simple mounting bracket on the back like this, and then taking a mirrored panel, just gluing it directly to the back like that, and simply put the candle on it, and there you have it. And
Courtney is going to love these.
Yeah, it's going to look cool.
My first place was a dream, getting out, away from my parents, being independent. And Courtney had that before. She had a job, she had a car, she had a great pad of her own, and then it was all taken away from her. And now she's getting it back.
Bring in the furniture!
No. Kitchen. Justin.
Ooh, look at this.
Hinges. We've got the colors that she likes. Apparently she really likes red and purple.
There's a lot of stuff in here. Keith, is it too big?
You have to rearrange the furniture.
Serious? It's not,
yeah.
But it's like
beach. It goes here, yeah, right here. No, it's not a message, it's a...
Oh, don't rip it.
No, it's not instructions.
Look, yes it is, it says instructions.
Oh, it is. Oh, I ripped it to shreds. It's coming together.
The team is putting the finishing touches on Courtney's gorgeous new suite. And after the break, she's finally going to get a chance to see it. Makeover began with not one letter, but dozens of them, telling us the story of Courtney's tragic accident and amazing recovery. They said she'd never walk and never talk, but Courtney continues to defy the odds. And now she's at a turning point in her life, and she definitely is ready to live independently. She's on her way home now, and we can't wait to see her reaction. It's all hands on deck as Keith and his design team put the finishing touches on all three of Courtney's new rooms.
Now, who knows how to set the timer on the microwave? After meeting Courtney, I'm honestly honored to have done this for her.
What was once a neglected basement full of forgotten storage is now a gorgeous urban apartment for an independent young woman. Keith and his design team took a tired rec room and transformed it into a lush, youthful living area for Courtney. The walls have come alive with rich graphic earth tones to complement the plush poppy red sofa. A strong accent in Courtney's favorite shade that perfectly plays off the fresh slipper chairs in coordinating colors. A tight corridor that served as a laundry room was expanded into a sleek and fresh kitchen for Courtney to relearn how to cook for herself. Stainless steel countertops and appliance racks create a spacious feel, and the lime green accent adds punch to the mid-century modern table in crisp white. A simple spare room is now a luxurious bedroom that's both contemporary and comfortable. The warm gray tones give Courtney a spa-like retreat, perfect for her new queen-size bed. Keith turned a protruding foundation flaw into a clever bench area, complete with a banquette in nature-inspired patterns. And we couldn't forget Courtney's hero, country star Keith Urban. It's a youthful, elegant apartment for a wonderful woman entering the next phase of her life.
Keith, you did it. Mm-hmm. This makeover is beautiful.
Yeah, you know what? It turned out really well. I'm really, really ecstatic about it. I can't wait to see her reaction. The goal was to give Courtney back her independence, and I think we've achieved it. I think she has everything she needs to start her life.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Well, let's get it going on. Okay. I'm gonna go get her.
All right.
How's she gonna react? I think she's just gonna go crazy. She's gonna jump off the walls.
Hi.
How are ya?
Oh, good. How are you?
Good. Nice to see you.
She's gonna jump around and laugh and cry.
You know what? She can jump.
She's gonna go loco.
Your new living room, girl.
Oh, my God.
Check out your little oasis.
She loves Keith Urban, loves talking about him, loves listening to his music.
You've got your buddy Keith to stare at while you're laying.
She loves her family and her friends, and she's always just a pleasant person to be around. She makes our lives complete.
Oh, Marnie, I'm so happy.
I'm so happy for you.
Well, we did it. Courtney loves it. She has her independence back, and she can go on and live her life. Come on, test out the new bed. Because this might be the last time you're allowed in here. Hey, Courtney.
Yep, this is my place.
Congratulations, sweetheart.
Well, mission accomplished. Courtney loves her brand new beautiful suite, and she's so excited to begin her life as a new independent woman once again. And we know she'll have no problems accomplishing that. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time for another inspiring story on Makeover Wish.
Guess what? The place where I go sleep? Yeah. Guess what? Keith Urban is right there!
Very
old Pat. Yep. And Mom and Dad, they live up there. They can't come in here until they say, Courtney, can we come in? And if I say no, too bad for them. But they're my mom and dad. I love them. Of course I'll let them come in.